I mean, it's just, think about this. This is what really blows me away. This statistic here from Pro Football Focus on Justin Jefferson. Mm-hmm. When Burrow was throwing to him between 10 and 19 yards, which is, you know, like 60% of your throws as an NFL quarterback that get you big gains and stuff like that. Burrow had 147.9 quarterback rating when throwing between 10 and 19 yards, those intermediate passes to Justin Jefferson. They were just dominant. He led the entire nation in slot receptions, slot yards. I mean, this is a guy who knows how to get open. And by the way, when I say not a burner, he ran a 4.43.
Okay.
So, I mean, he's fast enough. As hell. Yeah.
What was Laquon Treadwell?
A 4.63. And yeah. I still don't think that's the reason Treadwell failed, but. And his vertical jump was 38 inches. So, I mean, you are talking about not somebody that, oh, well, he's just a route runner or whatever. He is fast. And his comparison from Pro Football Focus is Marvin Jones, who's a star for the Detroit Lions. Mm-hmm. This is a guy that you have to pick here. And if they didn't, I now at this point would be pretty surprised.
Indications are that it will be Justin Jefferson, but we're still waiting for Roger Goodell. I'm mostly just waiting to see like how Roger Goodell interacts with the Vikings fans on Zoom at this point. He's been very smooth with all the other fan bases.
Incredibly uncomfortable.
Yeah, and I want to see like, are they actual Vikings fans or are they just like people from the Vikings organization that we probably know that they planted in the Zoom with horns on and things? I guess we'll find out here shortly.
I think they are real people.
But you can't like, can you trust
them?
No,
you can't. Really, they haven't shown any close-ups of that.
Of the 16 people.
Yeah, we've just sort of seen them in the background there. It was like somebody had that idea and they said, yeah, let's do it. And then it didn't really work out, but it's fine.
They should turn the volume on. Just turn the volume on and see what happens. See if somebody wants to drop a naughty one. Although ESPN has shown now by airing the uncensored Michael Jordan documentary that they don't really care about cuss words anymore after 8 o'clock.
Raj wouldn't like it though, man.
So the pick is in. ESPN's coverage is back here. And we're going to get this Vikings 22nd overall pick officially in just a second. You are listening to AM 1500 KSTP, St. Paul, Minneapolis. This is Score North and Score North's coverage of the NFL draft as part of our 36 hours of purple, powered by Dennis Kirk and the Canopy Group. And we appreciate you hanging with us since yesterday morning at 11 a.m. as we slice and dice and speculate on what the Vikings might do. Will they trade up? It winds up that they sit and stand pat at 22.
Totally the right move. We knew someone would drop. We just didn't know who. And it turns out in this case, it's Justin Jefferson. And the pick is not in an official, but I am certain that they are going to pick Justin Jefferson here and put him in the slot to go along with. I mean, think about how good this could work out for them in terms of Kirk Cousins' weapons if Jefferson is what we think he can be, which is a great route runner and all-around type of wide receiver who can line up everywhere. I mean, you'd have Thielen, him as someone who can make an instant impact, Irv Smith, Kyle Rudolph, Delvin Cook. But that is a good setup for Kirk Cousins in 2020, even though his chances of being Stephon Diggs are not high. But if you were going to pick a guy who I would say has a really good chance of being an 80 catch type of receiver who averages 14 yards a catch and things like that, I mean, I think that it's Justin Jefferson.
There's the Zim Ranch. There's the Spielman headquarters. Spielman's in a den of some kind.
Couple of dogs.
Zimmer literally has a Zimmer Ridge, some sort of like a cover on his fireplace.
Yeah, that's his deal in Kentucky, yeah.
Looks very nice, though. He has 18 different animal heads, taxidermy, on his wall.
There's a real live dog back there, though, so.
Are you sure that wasn't taxidermy?
At least one lived.
All right, the Vikings pick is in here.
Let's go. Come on, let's go, Viking fans.
Oh, wow.
Oh, boy.
There you go, Philly. Happy?
I love it.
Okay.
With the 22nd pick. In the 2020 draft, the Minnesota Vikings select Justin Jefferson, wide receiver, LSU.
Yep, this is an A. This is one of the home run scenarios. Take the wide receiver who drops. If they had stretched here to get Denzel Mims or even Jalen Reagor, I would have said, okay, I get it, but there's some worry with this guy. This is the least red flag player there is. I mean, he has done it at the highest level. A national champion who put up monster statistics, 18 touchdowns, 111 catches.
At age 9, third in the punt, pass, and kick national championship as well.
I know. That was something I worried about. And somebody who's got good size, 6'1", 200 pounds. He's in that that hot zone where you're not so tall that people can get their arms on you and slow you down. He also has really long arms, and he jumps high, and he runs fast. I mean, if this was any other draft, this might be the number one receiver on the board.
Yeah, he just look at his back of the football card statistics from last year alone, too, and they are eye-popping. This dude played 15 games, including the college football playoff, 111 catches for LSU last year for 1,540 yards. He averaged 14 yards per catch and 18 touchdowns against big boy competition. So Justin Jefferson becomes just the latest first-round draft pick wide receiver. The Vikings have had very mixed results with first-round draft pick wide receivers. There's the Randy Moss pick.
Yeah.
There's Percy Harvin, who worked out pretty well. But then there's also a small handful of busts in Troy Williamson. Cordero Patterson, to some extent, was a bust. And Laquan Treble was a bust. But what makes you think that – what's the number one thing to you that separates Justin Jefferson and his potential to be a good player versus a couple of the busts that they've had in recent years at this position?
I think that those other guys, you knew that there was that chance because of blank.
Yeah.
So with Troy Williamson, you knew there was a chance that he was just a burner who couldn't really do the technical things and didn't have good hands. Like, somebody doesn't have good hands as a receiver, that's pretty concerning. And the same thing with Laquan Treadwell. He had the injury. He was slowed down significantly by that. And also, when you played in that Ole Miss offense, that is not an NFL offense. In fact, it was the farthest thing in the world from an NFL offense, and it didn't ever really require Laquan Treadwell to be a route technician. They kind of just had him run down the field and throw him the ball, and he was stronger than everybody else. But with Justin Jefferson, his offense required him to run pristine routes, go up and make catches in the end zone, got a lot of great accurate passes from Joe Burrow that he's going to get from Kirk Cousins in the NFL too. And I don't know Justin Jefferson to say that for sure. He's a really smart guy, but in that offense, the way he excelled, I would guess he probably is. And then you say, all right, well, what's the physical traits then? The physical traits are also spectacular with him running a 4.43 at just over 200 pounds, and he has the length too. And so this is a guy that you can get the ball to run after catch and things like that. He's not LaVisca Chenault in terms of handing the ball to him and he's going to run for a touchdown, but he's also by no means slow. Like, this guy can run.
For the record, Mike Zimmer was shown smiling after the pick was made.
Interesting.
So, yes, it is an offensive player. He was smiling.
Yeah, he had no choice. They said, you got
it's
no choice.
It's a hostage situation.
Yeah, smile.
And
so, Cordero, too, was also, as I recall, when he was taken, he was a project and a great athlete, but he didn't have these type of stats, too. I don't think that Cordero had this type of background. The Vikings often have gotten in trouble. It feels like Treadwell's a little bit different than this, but certainly in the case of Williamson and Cordero, because they just thought that they were flat out getting great athletes. If
yes.
this kid can yep. if this kid can combine a knowledge of actual football, which I know sounds funny, but it's not. It's very important. If he can combine athletic ability with the fact that he can run routes and is a smart football player, that's the difference. Because Cordero, athletically, still gifted to this day.
Oh, yeah. Yep.
But what he couldn't do was he couldn't figure out how the game actually worked.
Yes.
And
yes,
this kid sounds
right.
like he can.
I think that there's a very good chance, based on the offense that he played in, that he will be able to do that. When you look at all the draft reports on him, they talk about he only have one season that was great, and it was last year. But when you're playing at LSU, that's kind of how it goes, because usually they're so talented that you're sort of next guy up and then you get your chance. This is somebody who does not necessarily have he could be the best receiver in the NFL type of thing that someone like Jerry Jeudy or Henry Ruggs, who could be maybe the most dangerous playmaker in the NFL. But it's more like, if he clicks, he ends up being Marvin Jones, Devontae Adams, or a little faster version of Devontae Adams, a little faster version of Adam Thielen. Somebody who is very, very good. And if he doesn't click, I still think he can be an effective player, and you can find certain routes where he could be good at, and he can use his athleticism to some extent. That's even if he doesn't become very, very good. Like, he doesn't have one of those big red flags, like you're saying with Cordero, where you're like, hey, so what's your best route that you run? Oh, I don't know. I don't run any of those. Like, you know,
yeah, I'm fast.
And then and Cordero had this thing too, where he, I mean, believed in himself to a fault would be the most polite way I can put it. So I remember there was a story about somebody, maybe it was Michael Irvin, offering him some advice on how to run routes. And he basically told him, hey, look, I don't really want that. And so, which is just the most Cordero thing ever. And I have not yet talked to Justin Jefferson. We will at some point tonight on a Zoom call, I'm sure. Or, you know, they'll put that out on Vikings.com, things like that. But I get the sense that he's probably a guy who understands the technical part of the game. And that is a big deal for fitting in with what Gary Kubiak wants to do. And he can be that deep burner. He can go down the field. They threw 9 deep passes over 20 yards to him last year, and 6 of them were touchdowns.
Okay.